Hi all, welcome to this course on production planning and control. Today we'll be learning about the largest candidate rule. So what is this largest candidate rule and the method for solving it is, in step 1, we should list all the elements in the descending order of their assigned times and largest the T or assigned time at is at the top of the list, or they are placed accordingly from the top of the list from descending order to the final order. Next, we go to the assigning of elements to the first workstation, which is start at the top of the list and work on selecting the first feasible element for placement at the station. A feasible element is one that satisfies the precedence requirements and does not cause the sum of all this time values at the station to exceed the cycle time, TC. Step 3, we continue the process of assigning work elements to the station as in step 2 until no further elements can be added without exceeding TC. Finally, we repeat the steps 2 and 3 for the other stations in the line until all the elements have been assigned. For example, if we have a work element from 1 to 12 and as per the work element of the descending order, we are arranging them as based upon the time which is taken. That is, work element 3 is coming first, which is 0.7. Work element 8, which is 0.6, is coming next. 11th element, which is 0.5, it is coming next to 0.4. Element 10, 0.38. Element 7, 0.32. Element 5, 0.3. Element 9, 0.27. Element 1, 0.2. Element 12, 0.12. Element 6, 0.11. And element 4, 0.1. And based upon these, the immediate predecessors are also being determined. And as per these predecessors, we draw the diagram or the sealant like ring diagram, which is shown below. 1, 2, which is going to 3 and 4, and 2 is coming to 4 and 5. From 3, 6, 7, and 8 are determined. 4 is giving rise to 8, 5 is giving rise to 10, 7 is giving rise to 9, 8 is giving rise to 9, and even 6 is going to 9. From there, all together, they are coming to 11, from which it is going to 12, which is 0.12, which is the last one. So based upon the same manner, according to the numbers and the minimum values and the predecessors and successors, we draw the diagram and find out the largest candidate rule using the TI, which is equals to 1 minute. So in order to find out that one, we'll just assume a values or we'll do iterations. Like 3, 8 and 11 are the required preceding elements. So element 2 is selected and alternatives are 5 and 1. It assigns element 5, where we get the value to be 0.7 minutes. Hence, the alternative 1 is assigning element 1, which gives us 0.9 minute. Alternative 3 and 4, which can be assigned, which is greater than TA. Hence, when we assign that element number 4, then we get the value to be 1 minute. So, based upon these minutes or the time which we have obtained, we can now move to the second iteration where element 3 is selected, where the alternatives are 8, 7 and 6. So, for 8 and 7, it cannot be obtained since the value is greater than the time which is assigned, and hence we assign the value of 6, which gives us the value of 0.81 minutes. And based upon that, we can again go to the third iteration where the element 8 is selected and the alternatives are 10 and 7. And according to that, we get the value to be 0.98 minute. And finally, from iteration number 4, we get the value of time, which is by assigning 9th element. We get the value to be 0.59 minutes and the alternative is 11, and it cannot be assigned since the value is greater than the time TD. Finally, in the iteration 5, element 11 is selected and the alternative is 12. So the total time is, or estimated time is, 0.62 minutes. All the elements are being assigned. So now we'll assign the values and we'll just use the final solution, which gives us the workstation of 1 to be 1 minute, workstation 2 to be 0.81 minute, workstation 3 to be 0.98 minute, workstation 4 to be 0.59 minute, workstation 5 to be 0.62 minutes. Hence, the solution is at station 1, 2514, station 2, 36, station 3, 810, station 4, 79, and station 5, 1112. Hence, this physical layout of workstations and assignment of elements are in this manner according to the largest candidate rule. Thank you.